The Sony A80J is part of Sony's new OLED lineup, and it's spectacular. It has more than enough to offer to the viewer, but more importantly, it's going to get better in the future, but more on that in a little bit. Welcome back, Charles from Gibbys Electronic Supermarket, and we are super excited to talk about the Sony A80J. Sony describes it as a TV with a premium OLED picture with truly immersive sound, and they aren't wrong. The A80J comes in three different sizes, a 55, a 65, and a 77-inch model. And the overall build of the TV itself feels pretty great. It's a little thicker than the A90J, but the materials used create a very premium feel. It should look great when it's mounted, and the TV's feet pose another great way to display it. The legs on the A80J come with three different positions. There is a raised option for the implementation of a soundbar, a lowered narrow stance, and a lowered wide stance. Now, this feature is great because you can choose how you set your TV up depending on your entertainment environment. Personally, since I don't use a soundbar, I like the ability to hide the cables and everything behind the TV. In addition to this, the stand provides a very suitable and stable base for the TV, so there's no worries there. Now, let's talk about the smart features on the A80J. It comes with Google TV instead of the Android TV, which is new for Sony, but it works just as well. It's easy to use, has a very user-friendly interface, and should not be a problem for any users out there. Google Assistant obviously tags along here, but also Amazon Alexa comes along with the package. With this, you'll be able to choose what to watch, control your music, or ask any questions you may have. All right, so moving on, let's talk about the overall performance of the TV. The A80J performs really well in most situations. HDR and movies on the A80J is a spectacular experience, plus with its wide viewing angles, you'll be able to watch tons of sports. The A80J is also a great TV for gaming. Although as of this moment, it does not support VRR, Sony has said that this will become available with future firmware updates. So this is another feature that will only make this TV better. With the near infinite contrast ratio, the A80J ranks among one of the top TVs along with many other OLED TVs. In addition to the contrast ratio, we have to look at the A80J's color gamut, with full coverage within DCI P3 color space and a very wide coverage in the Rec 2020 color space. HDR content will look absolutely stunning. Speaking of which, the A80J has HDR support for HDR10 and Dolby Vision. The A80J comes with a native refresh rate of 120Hz, and with an almost instantaneous response time like many other OLED TVs, it can handle motion with ease. With additional black frame insertion option, you can also calibrate it to deal with the motion blur a little better if need be. In terms of the supported resolutions, it supports 4K and 1080 at 120 and 60Hz with low input lag, so this should not be a problem if you're choosing to use this TV for gaming. As for the inputs, we have four HDMI inputs and an HDMI input 3 and 4 support HDMI 2.1. Now, ideally, it would be great to see HDMI 2.1 compatibility with all four of these inputs, but not totally necessary. And these two inputs should be more than enough for any sort of use. Lastly, we can talk about the audio. The A80J does have some pretty good punchy audio. Now, with the OLED TVs having such a slim profile, the A80J uses actuators that on the surface of the TV kind of act like a speaker. It hits the lower frequencies very well and produces a great overall audio experience. But in most cases, going with a soundbar or an audio system will provide a much more exciting and enhanced audio experience. All in all, the Sony A80J is a very impressive OLED TV wielding tons of potential for multiple different types of content. Now, if you like this video, give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, leave it down in the comment section below. Remember to subscribe and hit that bell. Until next time, guys, catch you in the next one. Back to you, camera. I don't know. All right, can you...